here now, this is a huge big size glass plate, and this is approximately 12 inches dia. So this is quite big, and your napkin size, usually what comes in the market, the German decoupage napkins is 12 inches. The decoupage papers what you get is A4 sizes, so you can always trim it down and use it on your plate. So I just felt that I will show you a video where you can use any kind of papers. So these are the few of the designs which I wanted to use. Now this is one of the beautiful paper which I have one. This is the another one. This is the third one. And this is the fourth one. Yeah, so we have few of the queries and explain every project. Oh, thank you so much, Namrata. First glass plate demo. So the first plate what I had shown you was not the glass plate, it was a plastic plate. Which type of plates these are? All these are like plastic plates, melamine plates, glass plates. So you can use any material. What to do to avoid painting peeling, that we will be showing during this session. So Anandi, do check this sessions completely. Kani, Kamit, yes, we will be showing all the processes what has to be done, and of course I will be also sharing with you all that what to do to avoid peeling off your paint. So do watch this video till the end. So I guess I have decided I am going to use this napkin so that I can show you the varieties of way in which you can work on this. Now this is going to be a reverse decoupage. So just for your reference, what is reverse decoupage? Now friends, when we supposedly, if I have a napkin, I have sticked it on a base, be it on any surface, this is going to be my decoupage work. Like if you see this, this is a plate on which I have sticked my napkin from the top. So this is a normal decoupage work. Hi Swarna, so good to see you here. Now this is a normal decoupage work. Now if I have to do reverse decoupage, so this is my glass plate. If you see on the top, there is nothing, but on the back side I have done the actual work. So this is called reverse decoupage. You have used your decoupage napkin, but you have sticked it from the back side of the plate. So this is a very basic difference between a decoupage and reverse decoupage. So hi Priya, you're from Indonesia. I'm so glad that I'm able to have some more people from different countries also. See, usually it is said that the decoupage napkins are the German napkins, but honestly I have tried few of the napkins from the local stores, the beautiful printed ones, and they have worked perfectly. So yes, you can use any of the normal tissues for your artwork. And I have also done a video on my YouTube channel where I had shown you that how you can make your own decoupage napkin. So if you just switch to my channel, my YouTube channel, you can check that. Okay girls, so now we are going to start. Now this is a big glass plate, so there are two options. Either I can have it sticked completely, or I can, like if I keep my plate like this, you can see the maximum design is just trimming out. So the only reason why I have picked up this napkin is because I wanted to show you that if you don't have a decoupage napkin, you can even use your decoupage papers or your pattern papers for this process. So what I'm going to do is I will trim down the design with my paint brush just to make sure that I have maximum design on my plate. So I will be doing this in patches. I will pick up first this part. Be a little careful when you are trimming off your design. You need to know that what exactly you want so that your work becomes easier. Now here it's done. So I have picked up one of my pieces. Kavita, no, these plates cannot be served. Like, if you get the varnish which is food safe, then only you can use these plates. If you don't have any of the varnishes which is made for edibles, then you cannot use these plates. Like, I'll show you. In this plate, I have been using this for more than a year now, and I have used this for serving food because I have done the reverse decoupage. On the front side, there is nothing. It is just a plain glass. So even if I serve something, I can easily clean it up. But if I do my decoupage work here, my food is going to come in contact with the artwork, with the supplies. So that's the reason you cannot use your food if you have done the decoupage on the top. But if it's a reverse decoupage, you can definitely use that. Now I am going to trim out the other portion also. Girls, in case if I miss out your questions now to reply, don't worry, as soon as our live sessions are over, then I will reply back to all your queries. So in case if I'm missing out, please don't be afraid, I will be replying back to each and every messages. I will just remind you again that we have a giveaway for this live session also. So please do share this as much as you can. Now this is a big chunk of piece which I'm trimming off now. And this looks great. I love the beautiful design, the butterfly and the flowers here. Dr. Kavita, I have already done a video on my channel where I have mentioned how to clean up your decoupage artwork. So I will share that link once my video is done, or you can check my channel, YouTube channel Growing Craft, and you can find all these videos there. Now I'll just do one thing, I'll keep my plate. And then I'll see that how this is turning out, because I need to know that I have covered the maximum area so that my plate looks beautiful. So I am planning to cover it as much as I can. So of course there are going to be some of the plus and minus points, but then it's okay, it's absolutely fine. If you girls have any query, you can ask me. If I'm not able to answer now, then definitely I will be able to answer it the moment I'm done with this session. So yeah, now I am doing some more trimming work. This is a very simple technique. Whenever you are working with your decoupage tissues, dip your paintbrush in a plain water and take out the excessive water. Make a nice border to the design, what do you want, and then very softly tear it off. So this is surely will be easier for you to work and remove the plies. If you are very good in fussy cutting work, then you can do that also, but then I just feel that it takes a little more time. See how easy it is to remove your napkins. So this is super easy. Just be a little gentle whenever you are using your napkins, and yes, I think I just need one more patch and then we can start with our work. Now here I am using a floral pattern. You can use any of the designs, you can use some of the beautiful symmetrical designs what you get, and then you can use it accordingly. This is a tissue paper which I am using right now, and yes, I remember I have to do a video on packing paper, which I will be doing very very soon. Girls, a little reminder, please do share this video as much as you can. We have a giveaway for this video session also. So So here I am using my heat gun. Now the best part of using our heat gun is that it makes your work much more easier. Removing your plies become much more easier. And of course, before we start sticking our napkin, we need to make sure that this dries out completely so that your sticking work becomes easier. Hi Ruchi. Hi Sudha. Can we use packing paper? Yes, of course. You can use rice paper, you can use pattern papers, you can use decoupage papers, you can use newspapers. You can use anything you want for your decoupage work. Now, it's time for me to remove the plies. Now, I have been asked many a times that why I remove the plies only after doing the trimming work. Now, I'll tell you this. This is a very important thing. See, now this is the actual napkin which I had used. So, this portion is left. Now, if I remove the napkin plies and then I do the trimming work, then I will be left with a very thin and a small piece of paper which is going to be very, very difficult to handle and to keep safely for the longer time, because I never ever throw the remaining portions of my napkin. I always use them on some other projects. So that's the reason I always first trim down the paper which I want, and then I remove the plies only of the designs which I need. So even if after trimming off I feel that no, I am not going to use that, then I do not remove the plies at all. It's just that it makes your handling easy. Of course, we can do this on plywood, Monali. It is very easy to do your decoupage work on plywood pieces. I have already done that. I have even done the image transfer also. The size of this plate is approximately 12 inches, and this is quite a big plate which I am using today. Girls, once again, thank you for so much love. I'm so overwhelmed with all the responses and all the videos, comments what you girls share. And yes, please do not forget to join our Facebook group where we have every month a giveaway for the people who share their projects. And yes, if you are inspired by my work, you can share your projects there. Even if not, you can share your projects. We would love to see your work too. Now, I am almost done with removing the plies here. This is the last one. Okay, so here I have removed all the plies. And now what I am going to do is I'll reverse my plate. Now this is called the reverse decoupage because we are going to decoupage on the back side of our plate. Okay, now this is the back side of my plate where I'm working. Can you see this? So now here we will start. Now I was asked that do I use only the DIY decoupage glue? No, it's not that. I use this Mod Podge a lot. This is one of my favorite. This is a matte finish Mod Podge which I highly recommend. If you don't have this, you can always make your own decoupage glue, which is also a video I have done and which is there on my channel. Rajlakshmi, so what happens is if I stick my paper there, you cannot see the base. Now if I remove the plies, can you see the difference? This is lighter, this is darker, because this is actually having the color. And when you do decoupage on the white surface, it actually enhances the colors of your project. Now we are going to start with our sticking work. So I've just taken few of my Mod Podge and I'll start from one of the areas. Let me keep this aside and yes, it is very, very important to remove the layers. So initially when I had started with my decoupage work, I was not even aware that we should remove the plies. I sticked my napkin as it is, and then later on I can see so many wrinkles there, and I could not see the proper white color on my project. So that's the reason I always mention this, that please do remove the layers of your napkins. Now here I'll start sticking. I've applied one layer of Mod Podge. Now with the same flat brush, I'm giving it a very nice brush up so that it sticks well to my base. You have to try to avoid wrinkles as much as you can. So it's not that you are not going to have any wrinkles. I still get, and I feel at times it's absolutely fine, because even I am also a learner. I'm also in this process of learning this art. So yeah, it's absolutely fine. Now we are done with the first portion of sticking work. Let me show you this from the front. So can you see this? This is how it looks. So that's the beauty of the reverse decoupage, that the front side is absolutely clean and on the back side you have your napkin. Now I am just going to press this a little more with my dry fingers, and then we'll move on to the next step. So first I'm trying to stick up all the bigger pieces so that later on we can arrange the smaller pieces. Girls, please do share this video as much as you can. And yes, we have a giveaway for this session also. Now I will be sticking up my second piece of napkin. Whenever you are doing your reverse decoupage, you will have to be a little careful that what amount of adhesive you are using. You have to be a little careful about that. And once if you know that this amount is just perfect, don't overdo your adhesive work. This will really save you when it comes to wrinkles. Okay, so here I'm done with my two portions. No, if you are using your decoupage tissue, then only you need to have your ply removing process. Otherwise, you need to stick that as it is. For like packing papers, for your pattern papers, for your decoupage papers, you don't need to remove the plies, because it is just a very thick paper. So you don't have to remove the plies at all. Here I have sticked my third paper also. So I'm just brushing this off with my same flat paintbrush. Now if you want to do the sticking process, you can always use your sponge dauber. Let me show you the sponge dauber. So these are the sponge dauber which I use for sticking my napkin, just in case if I'm not very comfortable with my flat brushes. Or you can even use a plastic sheets and press it on your tissue and they will stick well. I hope my video is clear, girls. So now it's time to stick another one. And here we are done. Now this is such a relaxing process. I really urge all of you to do this work and try this out. It's going to be really fun for you. Now I'm just adding the smaller pieces of my napkin here and there, and I just want to make sure that I have sticked it well on every nicks and the corners of my plate. So whenever you are using the same brush for sticking your napkin, make sure your brush does not have gesso, the decoupage glue or your Mod Podge, and make sure you press it well. No worries, Neha, this video is going to be there on my channel and even on my YouTube channel, so you can check them later on also. So but now also you can be here with us and we can interact. So here I think this looks good. Hi Reema. Pooja, you can get these Mod Podge from any of the local stores, and I am also going to share the links of Amazon from where you can get it home delivered. Now, as it's a lockdown time, I know it's not possible to step out, and it's better not to step out as much as you can. So avoid that, and for that I am sharing the link of Amazon once I'm done with this video on my channel, my YouTube channel, and on my page also. So on some of the areas my napkins are going to overlap like this, and it's absolutely fine because anyways we are going to play around with different colors on this, so it is going to get smudged and this will look beautiful. Don't worry about that at all. Now I have my last piece and I just want to make sure that I cover it up properly. Now here also my layers are on the top. It's absolutely fine with me. Okay, so here I am done and this is how my plate looks. Prema, let me check if I am getting the varnish right now. I will try to see if I can courier that, but for that you will have to give me a week's time to check and then maybe we can work out some way. Let me just check out in the market nearby. If I get, then I'll definitely post that on my page. Now I'm just thinking of having a couple of more pieces here, and for that very quickly I'll take up my round brush and I am going to have these leftover butterflies. So definitely we are not going to waste this at all. So I will tear off these butterflies so that we can stick this. Yes, absolutely. Like if you once I'm done with this live session, you check the starting of the video. In the starting of the video I have shown that what all varieties of work you can do on plates, be it your glass plates, your melamine plates or your plastic plates. So yes, in the starting of this live session I have shown that. Once we are done with this session, then definitely you can check that, and I'm sure you all are going to love that. So those who have joined right now, in the starting I have shared few of my glass plate projects, like what all I have done on glass plates, my plastic plate, my melamine plates, my reverse decoupage, my plain decoupage work with the flake work, and some of the color blending projects too. So do check this live session once we are done so that you can have a complete idea that what all kind of work you can do. See, the why we do the cutting work is just that if your napkin doesn't have a full design on it, like if it's just in the patchwork like what we had in this napkin, so in that case it's better if you cut it down so that you can play around with the colors. If you are happy with the colors, then you can have that color as you can use that napkin as it is and it's going to be absolutely fine. But if you want to do some color blending work, then I would suggest you to tear off your tissues or your papers and then do it. So I'm just sticking some of the butterflies here and there, and I'm trying to cover up the empty areas as much as I can. So I'm almost done with my napkin work, and because my napkin is so beautiful, this plate is looking so gorgeous already from the front side, like I've shown a couple of minutes back. No, the dryer what I'm using here is a heat gun. So what is heat gun? It's a tool which is used for embossing project, and it is also used for your drying process. It makes your work super easy, super faster. So yes, I would highly recommend you to check this. I have done a video where I have mentioned the difference in your hair dryer and your heat gun. So do check that too. So yes, I'm trying to stick it as much as I can because these butterflies are really cute. They are super cute, so I don't want to waste that. So yes, I think I am done. Okay, so now let me show you this from the front side, and this is how it's looking. So now let me turn this upside down. Now we will have to use our heat gun here. But as it's a glass plate, you have to be a little careful when you are using your heat gun and be safe. Yes, of course, why not, Indra? I have done a few of my decoupage work and even my image transfer work with the photographs, and just the process is a little different, and you need to be a little careful that how you are blending in the colors, and then it's perfectly fine to use any of the mediums there. I am so excited for this. It's looking gorgeous. This is turning out to be beautiful. Archana, we are making a decoupage, reverse decoupage on glass plate today. Girls, a little reminder, we have a giveaway for this video also. So please do share this on different groups as much as you can. That will be a really, really big help for me. Now the main work starts now. Once you are done with your decoupage napkin work, if you have tear them into these pieces and then sticked it, then you need to be really careful that how you are working on this. Okay, so here my drying process is done. It has dried out completely and this looks beautiful. This looks good. Let me remove this mat. Can you see this? I hope this is much more visible. Sonia, that giveaway session results will be announced by 1 o'clock today. I'm sorry, my laptop is not working, so I didn't get time to sit and announce the winner, but then that will be done by today afternoon. So we have a giveaway for this also, so please do share this one. Okay, now it's time to play around with my material, but here I need to play around with some of the supplies. And what do we need here? So either you can use your Mod Podge or you can use your decoupage glue. And what you need to do is seal up your napkins. Now why we need to seal up our napkin? Now we need to seal up our napkin just to make sure that if we are using any other mediums on the top of it, it should not absorb those colors. Okay, so here I will be having good one coat of my DIY decoupage glue. If you want, you can have your Mod Podge also. It's not going to make any difference. And girls, like it's, I can see so many crafters out there and so many budding crafters too. Please do join our Facebook page Growing Craft, where you can share your work and inspire others to create something beautiful. Now I am applying one coat of my decoupage glue here. Mosaic classes, yes, I do take mosaic classes. I take online classes also. For any of the online classes, my contact number is there on my page. You need to connect me on that for any of the classes or custom orders. In the decoupage technique, I have done decoupage on metal, decoupage on plastic, decoupage on cardboard, decoupage on furniture, and all those videos are there on my YouTube channel, and name of my channel is Growing Craft. So if you check our Instagram or if you check our YouTube, Facebook page, Facebook group, everything is in name of Growing Craft. Just check for Growing Craft and you can catch us. Preeti, I have left the spaces because we are going to use our stencil and we are going to do some nice color blending work here. Now, once I'm done with my decoupage glue sealing work, now I will have to dry this up again. So you have to be really careful when you are using your heat gun and make sure you are safe whenever you are using any these kind of tools. Let me keep up a box beneath that. And now I'll use my heat gun. So what I'm using here is not the hair dryer. So when I started my crafting journey, of course spending so much of money was not easy. So I have used my hair dryer for a very longer time, but when I really wanted to do some embossing work and when it was very difficult for me to work with my hair dryer, that's when I switched to this one. And this one is from Ranger. You can get this with any of the craft supply stores. 3D decoupage is something which has dimension to it. So please make sure that you check my YouTube channel where I have done 3D decoupage on glass bottle. I think I have done a frame also. So definitely that is going to help you all. Yes, of course, Mala, you can let it dry naturally. It takes a little more time, but then it will dry out. So if you don't have a heat gun or hair dryer, just switch on your fan and let it dry naturally and it will be super easy. Alternate of heat gun, see, when it comes to drying out, you can let it dry out naturally. You can let it dry out for just switch on the fan and let it dry, or else you can have your heat gun for drying. You can even use your hair dryer. It's absolutely fine. So here I am done with my drying process also. Let me show it to you again. And this is how it looks from the first side. So this is my back side of the plate. This is my front side of the plate. Now we are going to start with our white acrylic paint. Now here you can even use your gesso or you can even use your white acrylic paint. It's absolutely fine because we have already done the sealing work of our decoupage napkins. So what I'm going to do is I will just take up some of the white paint. And now, let me take up another brush, and now we are going to cover up our decoupage napkins. Now, this step is really important and I'll show you why. Let me just finish up doing the white paint work on some of the areas. And you need to make sure that wherever your design is, you are doing your white work on that surface. So I can just see that wherever my work is, let me show you. So if I see that this is my flower, so I'm going to cover this up with my white color paint. Okay. The more precisely you can do it, the more beautiful it is going to turn out. So I'm trying to cover this up as much as I can. Okay. If you don't have white color paint, you can use gesso. And that's absolutely fine. We have already sealed up our napkin once after the sticking work, so do not forget to use that step. That's really important. I'm just covering up my prints. Wherever I have the prints, I'm covering it up. I'm not doing it very precisely because, like I said, I am going to do some nice color blending work. So yes, I think this is looking quite good now. If your napkin has a complete print, like it has it is full of design, then you can color up your complete plate. It's absolutely fine. You don't have to do it in patches. This is the color which I'm using right now, Poonam, is a white acrylic paint. If you want, you can have a normal white chalk paint. If you want, you can have your gesso. It's absolutely fine. Now, why we do white paint here is because with your decoupage napkins, if it is done on a white surface, it pops out well. But here, as we are doing a reverse decoupage on the back side, on the top of decoupage napkin, there is no color at all. So how to highlight our napkins? The best way is to seal them up with a white color. So be it your acrylic white color, be it your chalk paint or your gesso, it doesn't matter. Now here we don't have to prep up our base because we are doing a reverse decoupage. If you are doing it on MDF or plastic or any of such materials, then you might need gesso. I would prefer you, and I would suggest you to go for gesso so that your base preps up well and you have a good area to work on. Girls, I hope you all are sharing this video as much as you can, and you girls are helping me out. Of course, we have a giveaway for this one too. Now we are almost done. Let me show you some of the areas where I have done the white color, where I have not done the white color. So can you make out the difference? Let me remove this mat. And now my table is dark brown. So can you really see that here I have done a white color? So these flowers are so clear. Here I have not done any on the white color on the back side. So you cannot see these flowers clearly. Is it visible, girls? Is it visible? And now can you make out that why having a white color on beneath your decoupage napkin is important? Because if you don't have the white color base, can you see in even in this flower, I have done white color on this portion from the back side. So this flower colors and shades are so much visible, but here this is not visible at all. So that's a very important thing, and that's the reason we have to do decoupage work on the white surface. I'm brushing up on the areas, and I think this is looking great now. The napkin is beautiful, so of course your work becomes much more easier. You just have to play around with the colors and they work so well here. Even if you miss out some of the areas, it's absolutely fine, girls. Don't worry, you can do it later on, and then you can do your blending work and the stencil work. And even if you missed out after that, it's absolutely fine. So if you play around beautifully with your stencils and other colors, it will work perfectly for sure. And I guess that's the beauty of doing decoupage work. So in art, like we say, there is nothing mistakes. It's always something beautiful what you are creating. It's always something nice and interesting what you are making. So I am almost done with my white color. Just a bit of touch-up work is required here and there. And yes, here I think I should do the complete white color, because this area is full of my floral print decoupage napkin. So yes, this is Done. I am almost done and I'm quite happy with this one. Now, before I show you the front side of this plate, I just want to make sure that it dries well. So again, I will be using my heat gun. Prima, don't worry. This video is going to be there on my Facebook page and also on my YouTube channel. So you can see it again and again and you can learn and create something beautiful. Shushmita, if you use black color, the napkin is not going to have a very nice popping color. Preferably white, but definitely you can try with some other darker shades. And if that works out for you, then nothing like it. There's nothing wrong in trying out the different shades. So yes, you can try it out. Yes, yes, Yogita, you can definitely wash this, but there is a proper step to wash this, and I am going to list that video link where I have shown you that how you can clean up your decoupage plates or your decoupage artwork so that it's easier for you to understand. Okay, so here I am done, and let me show you. So this is how it looks, and it looks gorgeous. I am loving these flowers. Yes, these are washables, but there is a limit to it. There is a condition to it, and I have already done a video about how to clean up your decoupage surfaces, and I will share that link once I'm done with this tutorial. Now it's time to play around with our stencils, and I don't know which one to use. So I think I will go with this one. This is again another floral pattern, and which color we should have? I'm a bit confused now. Let us have some nice bright color. So, or maybe we can just have a green color. Let me try this with a nice green color. So here I'm going to use a green color chalk paint, and I will take a base on which I can use my color. So my craft room is in a complete mess now, because I've been doing back-to-back live sessions, so it's in a big mess. Yes, of course, we will have to varnish this for sure. So yes, now this is a sponge robber. So you get this in a set of 5 or 6 pieces of different sizes, and this is the second smallest one. And I have taken up my green color on an acrylic block. I'm just trying to remove all the excessive color from this. And now I will start doing up my stencil work here. Now in my pattern, I can see some beautiful leaves. So I'm trying to do the leaves area the most. And here I'm using a chalk paint. If you want, you can go ahead and use acrylic paints too. It's absolutely fine. Now girls, when you are doing this step, if you don't have this sponge dauber, you can take a piece of sponge, but then it's going to be a little messy, but of course you will get the same result. So there's always an alternate if you don't have these tools. Of course the results are going to be a little different for sure. Okay, so now let me show you how this is looking. Can you see this? Now I will turn it to the front side, and can you see the difference? Now here this is actually looking like more of a leaves to my plate. So I'm going to repeat this, and I'll tell you again that here what I'm using is a stencil, and the applicator what I'm using here is a sponge dauber, and the paint what I'm using here is a chalk paint. Now there is no compulsion that you have to use your chalk paints only. You can use your acrylic paints also, but chalk paints don't come out so easily, and once you seal it up, it's going to last really, really long. So yes, that's one of the plus points of the sponge dauber and your chalk paints. So now I am going to repeat this process on all the parts. I'm taking some more chalk paints here. Again, I'll dip it in my brush. I'll take out the excessive ones. If you have excessive chalk paint on your sponge dauber, what's going to happen is that it will smudge. It will just go beneath your stencils and it might ruin your project. So try to take out all the excessive colors from your sponge dauber and then do it. So that will make your work easier too. I'm just trying to fold up the napkins wherever I can and I am trying to do my stencil work. Okay, now this is good. If you don't have stencil, you can do the painting work. I'm very bad with painting work, so that is something which I don't try at all. So the stencil here what I'm using is from Craft Treats, and some of my favorite brands of my stencils are from Craftologo, from Craft Treats. The Tim Holtz, it's also one of my favorite stencils which I've been using for years and it has not changed at all. So yes, you can check that also. Now this process takes a little time, but this is such a relaxing process. I really love it when I'm doing these kind of stencil work. Let me just finish up some more patchwork with my green color so that later on we can move on to the next coloring pattern. So here I am done with my stencil work. Let me show you this. And can you make out that it was a different stencil what I have used? Not at all. Now again we will have to dry this and make sure that whenever you are using your paint brushes, palette knife or sponge dauber, to dip them in water immediately so that next time when you have to wash it, it becomes easier. Now I will be using my heat gun to dry this up. I have removed the mat from my table so that I can show you that how my colors are coming out. Without mat it's much more visible. Jaina, I am going to share all the links down below once I'm done with this live session of all the material what I'm using here. You can buy them from Amazon. The links are going to be there as soon as I'm done with this video. The green color what I have used with my stencil is a chalk paint and I have used that so that I can blend in with my pattern. So if you are using any symmetrical pattern, you can use the stencils of that kind and that will be really helpful. Now it's time to move on to the next and a very interesting step which is going to change the look and feel of your project. Now here what I have is a mango milkshake shade. I love this shade. This is one of my favorite shades in chalk paint and I'm going to use this for my background. Now if you don't have a chalk paint, you can try out with acrylic colors, and if you are getting the effect what you want, then nothing like it. You can use any of the colors. There's no compulsion that you have to use chalk paint only. So here I am going to cover up my complete plate with my chalk paint. I will show you the front side of it for sure. Girls, a little reminder, we have a giveaway with this live session and please do share this video as much as you can on different groups, and one lucky winner is going to get a gift from our store. Let me finish up half of the plate so that I can show you that how this is turning out. Now, why I am not using a flat paint brush and why I am using a sponge dauber. Now, if you use your sponge dauber, it really gels up with your base so well that you do not see any of the marks here. So that's the reason I prefer to have a sponge dauber. But if, like I always say, if you don't have a sponge dauber, you can use a sponge piece, or you can even use your paint brushes, but just that you need to be a little careful. That's it. Otherwise, it's absolutely fine. So I'm dabbing up my color. Let me keep a cloth so that my plate doesn't get any scratches. I hope my video is clear. Girls, if you have anything to share, you can check our Facebook group in the name of Growing Craft, where we really love to see the varieties of work you do to inspire us. And you need to search for Growing Craft and you can share your artworks there, and we would love to see that too. This looks interesting. The back side is yellowish and our front side is going to have some really nice color combination. Now let me show you the front side of this plate, because we have already done the half portion of this plate so that you can see the difference. And can you see the difference? Can you see that how it looks? So in this area, I have done my yellow color chalk paint, and this is the area where I have not done any of the chalk paints. So this is looking like a more of a natural or beautiful floral scene. Now we will be repeating this process on the complete plate. The paint what I'm using here is a chalk paint. If you don't have a chalk paint, you can always use your acrylic paints. It's absolutely fine. You just need to love the shades whatever you have. See, when I'm doing my color blending work, Vijayta, then I prefer to add a little water. But if I am not doing any color blending work, then I prefer not to use water at all, because the colors what you get is already is in a liquid form, so you don't have to add water to it for sure. But yes, like I said, if I'm doing a color blending work, like if you see my yesterday's live channel, live session, there I had used loads of water to blend it. So for color blending, of course, you will need to dilute the water. That's the way I like it. Prema, you will have to use a varnish to seal up your project. That's a very important step. I know, because of lockdown, we are not getting many of the supplies and there is no alternate to varnish at all. Please, please, please varnish all your artworks as soon as you are done so that it lasts longer. I'm just trying to clean up my bottle as soon as I'm done with my coloring work. So yeah, Anupa, this is a reverse decoupage what we are doing today on a glass plate. So if you watch this live session later on, you can see that initially, or like on the starting of this video, I have shown you many of my projects which I have done on glass plate, melamine plate, plastic plates, and all those videos are there on my YouTube channel. If you have not subscribed to my YouTube channel, you can check for Growing Craft on YouTube and you will find us. We are there on Instagram, we are there on Facebook, we have our own Facebook group where we encourage people to share their work so that we can see the variety of work and inspire each other. Now here I am done with my coloring work. wherever I can see some of the patches, I'm just covering it up. If you are not happy with your one coat, you can always go for two coats. But I'm quite happy with my one coat of color. Now I need to close up my bottle and I need to bring it to the center so that I can dry it out. And again, I will be using my heat gun. So for hanging, you can use some of the hooks which are available in the market. At the end of this video, I'll definitely show you that. And you can use that and stick your any kind of projects and hang them and decorate your wall. Yes, Prema, I'm eagerly waiting to see the project. So please share your projects on our Facebook group. The name of our group is growingcraft.com. Sorry, the Growing Craft. You just have to type Growing Craft on Facebook and you can see our page, you can see our group, and you can even just check our YouTube channel too. Monali's live session, two more. I didn't get you. You want me to do one more live session today? I'm not sure what you are asking. If you can just clear that out. And girl, please help me by sharing this video as much as you can. It really encourages me to see the number of people are getting inspired and creating something beautiful. Now my chalk paint has almost dried out. And wow, this is how my plate is looking. Let me just zoom in a bit. Can you see this? How beautiful. Earlier it was a plain white, the clear plate, and now it looks absolutely beautiful. Do let me know in the comment section later on if you like this video, and if you girls have any of the suggestions for me, then please tell me that also. Now here I have taken a sandpaper. This is a very important step, and I am going to rub all the excessive papers from the sides. How to do it? Take your sandpaper. Now this is really, really important. This is the area I have worked on, and this is the area, the front side. So how you need to trim off the excessive paper, take up your either the nail file, or you can even have the sandpaper and rub it on the other side of this. So wherever you see your excessive napkin, just rub it off and you will see all the extra papers are going to come out. So just be a little gentle because it's a glass plate and we don't want to ruin this for sure. So just a bit of trimming work and all your excessive papers will be out. So in the some of the areas you will feel that your paint is coming out or your paper has trimmed out a little more. Don't worry, you can always cover those areas with your paints. So which color to use, you can choose any of the shades, but preferably it should be the one which you have used for your base coat here. Okay, now this is done. Let me clean this up. And yes, this is how my plate looks now. Yes, it has turned out beautiful, beautiful, Himanshi. Even I am also loving this one. Now I'll just take up all the excessive papers if I see anything. And now can you even make out that I have sticked these pieces separately? Not at all. This looks absolutely beautiful. Monali, any live session tomorrow? Let me see. Let me plan out if I'm coming tomorrow live, then definitely I will tell you all in advance. I try to plan my sessions a day in advance, but it never happens. So like for today's session, I had mentioned that today morning I just thought that I can do a live session. So that's when I did it. So it's very difficult for me to plan out in advance, but yes, from the next time I will try to do that in advance as much as I can. I'm just trying to make sure that it dries out really well, because still one of the very important step is left here, which is sealing up my project, which is really important. So yes, you have to keep that in mind, that you seal all your projects really well. Okay, so here I am done with my drying process. This plates looks absolutely gorgeous and beautiful. Girls, please do not forget to share this video as much as you can. That will be a really big help for me, for sure. Now it's time to seal this up. Hi Megha, you are so late today. Please do check this video later on so that you do not miss out on anything. And girls, if you are creating something, then please, please, please do share that on our Facebook group. It's in the name of Growing Craft, and we would love to see your projects too. Now here I am using my water-based varnish, the Asian Paint water-based varnish, to seal this project. Now usually whenever I'm doing my live sessions or I'm doing my videos, I do one coat of varnish, but after that I always apply good 2-3 coats of varnish. Now whenever you are doing your varnish work, you need to let it dry for at least 3-4 hours, and then you do your varnish, the next layer of your varnish. You need to give it ample amount of time to dry out. Shubha, yes, definitely we can plan out another session with a decoupage on bottle. And I just hope that this session didn't took too much of time. So yes, I am done with my first coat of varnish. Now here I will be using my heat gun to dry this up so that I can show you the front side. And yes, again I will be showing all the plates what I have done earlier, so that it's easy for you to understand that what kind of work I have done on this plate and what kind of work I have done on my previous plate. Thank you so much for Dipti. Bindiya, yes, you can wash this, but there is a thumb rule for this. I will share that video really soon on my Facebook page so that you can check it out, and you please don't miss out that video because it's really important, and that's going to really help you, not even only with this plate but even for your future projects too. Now the tool which I'm using here is my heat gun. This really helps in speeding up my drying process. The sealer what I have used here is that's my water-based varnish from Asian Paints. This is the same technique which you can use on your furnitures also, but the only difference is you will have to prep up your base with gesso, then you will have to stick your napkins, and rest of the steps are going to be really, really same. Thank you so much, Monali. Thank you so much for joining us today. And yes, girls, again a small request, please do share this video as much as you can so that it really helps me in with more visibility, and I can get more suggestions and feedbacks, and that is really going to help me to grow up in my crafting work. And my today's project is done. This is looking beautiful. I'm absolutely in love with this one. Now let me show you the other plates which I have done earlier. Now this is a melamine plate. This is a plastic plate. This is the what we have done now. This is a glass plate. Now in this one I have used a photo. Someone had asked me during this live session, can we use photo? So I will like to show you the backside of this. Now if you see the square line, this is a photo what I have used. Then On the sides, what you see is a pattern, my decoupage napkin. This floral pattern is decoupage napkin. So I have used my decoupage napkin. I have not sealed up this area so that I can show you that on the top of the picture, I have used my napkin on this much portion. And then on this area, first I did my stencil work. And then I sealed it up with the red color chalk paint. And then at the end, I have sealed my completed project. So the reason why I did not seal up this area because I wanted to show you all that whenever I had just thought that whenever I'm going to do any of my live sessions, I'm going to show that how beautifully you can do your decoupage with your photographs, with your decoupage napkins. You can even use your stencil work. You can even do this in on wood also, for sure, Mati. So, if you see this one, I had not covered this completely. So, let me show you with a lighter shade. Let me check. Okay. So, can you see some of the area has the white shade? Because I had not sealed up completely, I wanted to have some of the transparent areas. So in this one, I have done reverse decoupage with photograph and decoupage napkin and some stencil work. Now, this is a melamine plate. And in this one, I have used my decoupage and my flakes. And this is an absolutely gorgeous and a beautiful project. Now, in this one, I have used my rice paper and I have used my stencil work. And I have done a decoupage here. Now this is a project which is one of my favorites. Here I have done a reverse decoupage and this is how it looks. And this is a project what we have created today. I really hope that today's session was something interesting for you. And I hope you all liked it. If you want me to do a video on how to use photograph for decoupage, do let me know in the comment section. I will be more than happy to help you all. And I need to announce the winners of my first live session. So the winner of my first live session is Sonia Khurana. Please do send us your postal address at sonia.agarwal@gmail.com. And congratulations, Sonia, and for our yesterday's live session and this one, we are having a huge giveaway. So please do share these videos as much as you can. Now, the last and the very important thing, how to hang these plates. Now, you get these kind of hooks in the market. Okay, now, of course, we cannot do any of the drill work on this. So how to stick is, you just take up these ones. Then you can have this fairy bond. Stick it on the back side of your plate and you can hang it. So right now, this plate does not have any hook. So let me do this here on camera for you all and show it to you. Let me just make some space here. Okay. So I'll just put it back. I need to make sure that this is my center point. I'm going to have my fabi bond. Now this one has two portions. This is a flat portion. On the flat portion, you need to apply your fabi bond generously. If you have E6000, you can use that also. And now we are going to stick this. Now let me show you how it has turned up. So this is my hook. This is going to be my front side and I'll just keep it pressed for some time, and once it dries out, you can hang up your any of the decorative plates and it's going to work well. So friends, with this, today's video is done. Today we have created this and I really hope that you all like this video. Please do share this as much as you can and do let me know what do you want to see on our next session. And of course, I will be sharing all the requested links as soon as we are done with this video. Thank you so much for watching, friends. Take care. Bye-bye.